One of the very interesting things we're coming to is saying where, I think of in terms of crowds, in terms of where are crowds best, where are individuals best. And, you know, crowds can be small or large. And I think there are certainly some domains where decision making should be done individually or by small groups. That is either we get less effective outcomes, or it is just simply too unwieldy to get many people together. So I think we do need to go through a process of exploring further how we can build, firstly, effective collaborative decision making, and how to build beyond that. How can we build effective crowd decision making? But distinguish, and we don't really have the evidence yet. I think we can intuitively get some sense as to where decisions are better made by individuals or others, but we still need to get some better insights by trying. See, so, you know, are there some mechanisms whereby we can bring crowds together better to or groups to be able to make decisions effectively? And what are those mechanisms? And I think increasingly those are the crowd mechanisms, which I think are essentially the collaborative mechanisms, are about suggesting ideas, being able to filter them, be able to, vote is just one of the mechanisms to be able to do that, to essentially shape and to filter and to also find how people with different backgrounds or contexts have different views. That's where we start to get value, is when we get different perspectives to bear, but we're still really creating some of those processes whereby the collaborative decisions can be matched against individual or small group decisions and see, well, what are the quality? How can we compare how these decisions perform in real life situations? So collaboration, you know, coming from the Latin, collaborare, to work together. And it's been able to, you know, collaboration is really how do you get individuals or groups or organizations to work together to create something that they could not have done individually or they can do better together. So from my idea, to my mind, collaboration spans all of humanity. It is about how we can work together. And to an increasing extent, that means that organizations, as we understand them, are less relevant. It doesn't mean they're still not relevant or important or driving things, but we can, as we have collaboration within organizations, increasingly spanning boundaries to collaboration with customers, with suppliers, with partners, with increasingly competitors, that the boundaries of the organizations are blurring. I think what we can begin to see is this landscape where this collaboration, the sense of creating value together, starts to transcend the organizational forms of today. So one of the big questions, one of the big uncertainties moving forward is the degree which we'll have large organizations and the shape that organizations, small and large, will take. I think we will still have large organizations. They will, the more successful ones, will increasingly have a lot of value creation across their boundaries. And the smaller organizations that are successful will increasingly be virtualized in terms of where it's really been very hard to define. Where is value created, either inside or across organizational boundaries? Collaboration will happen inside organizations, but the value will increasingly be distributed across a broader scope, making the organization gradually less relevant.
Mm. So you think the community is getting more important than organization by themselves?
Yes, the value creation spans boundaries, and sometimes that will be corralled within an organization, less, you know, more frequently it won't be. So the what is relevant, what is important is, you know, the domain within which value is created, and that is less important than the organizational shape. That can happen within an organization, can happen across several organizations, can be just a whole set of individuals today. So the collaboration is the driver, the organizational shape is less important.